Hi, this is Aziz Al-Maksud. Today I'm here with very important and the topmost project for the Kubernetes. Every employer or recruiter wants to know, have you worked with EFK? If you say EKS, then have you worked with EFK? Means Elasticsearch, Fluentd, and Kibana. So after having the monitoring with Prometheus and Grafana, you have the metrics. So for logging, you have to go to Fluentd and Kibana. It's for logging. And I made this project today very high level, very standard. Project roadmap is like this. I'll create a bastion host. Automate the installation of the pre-requisites like AWS CLI, kubectl, Eksctl with a shell script. Then I'll create EKS cluster. Then I'll create the backend deployment with environment variables in a declarative way. First the backend. Then I'll install Helm and then run MySQL using Helm. This is very important. Running MySQL using Helm is a part of the interview question also. Interviewer wants to know that. It's very secured and very standard. Then I'll configure the database. Here you will get the flavor or real-time experience how to configure database in the bash. Then I'll run the backend application with the help of ConfigMap. Here, I'll introduce you guys with the ConfigMap to serve the environment variables. Guys, ConfigMap is very much useful. And in LARS, it's used almost all the scenarios like that to today in the Kubernetes. So config map you have to master. If you can master the config map, honestly, you will be the really pro in the Kubernetes. Then I'll run deployment with changed resources configuration. Then I'll incorporate liveness and liveness probe and readiness probe. These two cushions must be had in the interview, must be. Liveness and readiness in the Kubernetes, you must be master, okay? You should be expert there. What is liveness and what is readiness? Readiness of the pod becomes only one time, but liveness, it should be multiple times, maybe million times in the project. So you have to know how to write the liveness probe and readiness probe in the YAML file. I'll show you everything from my real-time experience. Then I'll create a custom Helm chart for the application and run it. Finally, I'll incorporate EFK, Elasticsearch, Fluentd, and Kibana for logging. Man, logging must be had. After having the metrics from Prometheus and Grafana, you have to jump into the Elasticsearch, Fluentd, and Kibana. Then you can do your troubleshooting rightly. What's the problem is there, okay? Okay, so let's go to the project. And if you missed my earlier videos, please start, because it started the Kubernetes intro to the pro from here. First here, then here, then here, then here, then here, then here. Today, I'm adding the last portion of Kubernetes series. It will be also maybe two or three parts. I'm not sure how much energy and time I have, because all day I had to work. Now this is night time. And this is a part of actually AWS DevOps engineering. If you like to be AWS DevOps engineer, then I will suggest please follow from here. Three-tier deployment with VPC, Nginx, load balancer, auto scaling. From here, then here, then here, then here, the Kubernetes, this is the Docker started from here. So just follow from like this. And this is the part 4 of Kubernetes I am starting today. So after having the part 4, Kubernetes will be finished. Then I will go to the CI/CD also. Then Ansible mastering. Then Vault, how to master the Vault. Then also Jenkins. So keep in touch, guys. And my GitHub is here. If you like to see my GitHub, everything is here. Okay, first of all, I have to create a bastion. Bastion is very simple. Just name the bastion. I'm using Ubuntu. Then D2 micro is okay. All it I have keep here. If you don't have, just get from here. Then I have the VPC should be auto assigned. Public IP should be enabled. So this subnet will be by default public, because public IP will be enabled. Already I have the default one. It should be all traffic or at least the SSS. Okay, let's create from here. And also I need to have the mobile extern. Just I'm making everything easy. Instances. I have only now one bastion, public IPv4 address, session, SSS, control V, then Ubuntu. Sound is not Ubuntu, it's actually Ubuntu. Then this is the three tier PIM. My key is here. Okay, now I'm showing you how to update in the declarative way and mostly used in the industry right now. First of all, I'm editing or creating meme install.ss. Meaningful name, you should have install.ss. Should be I insert. And already I have the GitHub install.ss paste repo here. The installation, which one? This one. Eksctl. See here. First the update, then upgrade, then AWS CLI installation, then kubectl installation, Eksctl installation. Then it will verify the checksum. Then tar xjf. Then sudo mb temp. Eksctl, it will be moved from here to here in the bin, user local bin. So let's see in the real time. Copy from here and insert here. WQ. Now I have to give the permission. I have here install.ss, but it does not have the permission to be executed. Chmod plus x, then install.ss cls. Now color is changed. If the color is changed like this, then that means that you have the permission of execution. How to do execution? This is also interview question, guys. I'm sharing you guys with interview question also. The execution start any file ./ the file name. You have to have the permission for us to be executed. See, plus x, then it's reading everything. And see here, one more thing, when this is executing, you have to know, you have to see how it's been done here. This is in the EC2 archive. How did archive? It's using the C in the background, Python 3. Lib PAM modules bin AMD is using AMD here also, and then it's coming to the installation next process. Every process is going good. Okay, you have to see these kinds of red or this colored guys, no schema files found, doing nothing. Okay, I don't need the schema file here. Okay, something is failure, it's okay. Because not needed that one. Okay, failed. Okay, that's not I needed. Okay, setting is done here. That's good. Creating, okay, AWS list. Okay, everything is good. Creating. See, this is important. When you see that anything red, then if you come like this, creating, that means basically most of the times, system has taken by default the latest one. Without taking the latest, it's not making the creating, or without taking any information. It's good. So it's already created. Eksctl md 64 tar gs is created already. Okay, let's see here. It's still there like this. Now I have to do AWS configure. For AWS configuration, I have to create IAM user. So IAM user is where? IAM user is here. I'm making one more tab from here. So users, already I have one, but I am creating one more. I'm giving the name user for EFK. And just attaching policy directly, giving the highest policy permission, administrator access. This is also interview question. Which permission is the highest for the user? Administrator access. This is the highest one. Just creating. This is the EFK one. Today I have created. Security credentials. I have to go there. I need the access key. Create access key is for CLI, right? We're using the CLI. Okay. I have to confirm. I have read everything. Then create the access key. And industry practice is to be saved. Download .csv file. But after this demo, I'm just deleting my resources. So just I don't need it. Okay. Just I'm keeping like this. I just copy it from here. AWS configure. So here access key ID, enter. This is the secret access key I'm showing you guys. This is the secret because I'm deleting. Okay. So one more thing, access key has two things. One is access key and another is secret access key. Everything has public and private key. For the security purpose. So which one is public and which one is private? This is also interview question. Access key, this is the public, and secret access key is the private. And one more thing, always private is the longer one. See, this is longer than this one. This is interesting. Okay, learn DevOps with interesting something amusement. Okay, try to laugh sometime. Okay, so default is then US East one. Default output JSON. Okay, so how to see this is working or not? AWS S3 LS. Yes, I have this bucket, my bucket US. Let's see, this bucket is existed or not. Where is S3? Yeah, I have this bucket. So this is now added with my account. So let's see one more time. AWS --- version. Yes. AWS CLI is running in the backend Python. This is also interview question, guys. Very important. AWS CLI running in the backend on Java or Python. Man, you must have to answer this. Okay. You have to have clear concept. Jenkins runs in the background on Java, but AWS runs on the background on Python. This is my learning like this. I just remember like this. Now I am adding some extra resources. Just adding this tar file. Okay. Oh, I have to have this file from a location. So I have to go this location first. I'm showing you the location. The latest EKS release. So which one is AMD64? This is the AMD64. I have to see the latest Eksctl release one. Yes, this one is here in the download. I have to upload this one. This is the same thing. I'm uploading here, see here, 0%, 10%, 11%. It's taking a bit time. Just adding the latest version. Eksctl 0.182.0. Release also same. So you DevOps guys, you have to always have the knowledge or access to the latest one, because latest package you have to have. It's done. How to see it's done or not? Ls, see, one more added here. Now the earlier command, this one will be working, because this is the tar.js file. It should be extracted, the files from inside tar-xzf. Extraction is x, then zf, then the file name .tar.js. Okay, it is extracted. Ls, see now. One more added here. It was earlier only this one here, see? Now extracted. This is one more added here. I don't need this one now. Okay. So rm eksctl tab. This is no need now. Ls, I need this one. But this eksctl, I have to move. I have to move to user local bin. So first of all, I have to go there, cd. I have to go there slash like this, users local bin. Ls, see here, one more eksctl here, right? So I have to remove this one. This is the older one. This is my new one, right? See here, I have to older rm. This is file. This is directory. So rf. I have to remove this one first. Oh, it should be sudo permission. Okay. Then go back. Ls, here this file I have to move here. How to move the file, guys? I'm showing you also Linux commands. Okay, so first I have to have the sudo permission, sudo mbmov eksctl to the location. Which location I have to go? I have to go this location. Okay, so sudo mov mbmov, this file means this one, this file will be moved to this location. Okay, this is real time Linux also showing you, okay, how to do in the real time, guys. So okay, enter. Now let's go this location. I have already this command. ls. See, earlier, after removing this Eksctl was gone. Now, my this Eksctl has been removed here. This one. Cd ls. See, here is no more Eksctl. Eksctl is moved there, and Eksctl has to be resided where? This is also in interview question. Eksctl resides, or also kubectl resides, user local bin. Guys, please memorize this one. User slash local slash bin. User slash, I remember like this. User goes to local, then the local bin or dumpster, okay? So user local bin. Kubectl, its brother is Eksctl, okay? So two brothers are living here. Also AWS, everything, AWS completer. So learn DevOps with smiling, guys. Okay, this is done now. I am now ready to edit the cluster. Now I have to create cluster beam cluster.yaml. I'm creating now cluster.yaml. I insert mode. I'm creating cluster using the YAML file. All the YAML files are stored in my database. So if you go here, where is paste repo? Yes, in the paste repo, EKS cluster. I'm creating now EKS cluster, cluster config. Okay, you can see cluster config also here. Either way, you can use already taken. So first of all, API version always, this is also interview question, describe the YAML file, anyone. First of all, API version, anything, any API version, then kind is the, is showing what kinds of this is. This is cluster config, this is the cluster config. Okay, so I'm just made this one shortened. Then metadata, then name. I have given the name like this: June 24 EKS, the region US East 1, node group, kind, metadata, see, same alignment, node group, same alignment, IAM, add-ons, it should be same alignment. And all the left side, see the lowercase, A, K, M, N, R, N, N, I, D, B, I, W, A, N, W, E. If you explain like this to the interviewer, all the left in the YAML is the lowercase, interviewer will be impressed. Okay, because some interviewer, honestly, they did not sometimes the focus or the left side, well, all the lowercase. Yeah, well, really nice. Then okay, API version, kind, metadata, node groups. Node group has the name, instance type, T3 large I'm using. Dessert is 2, and you can take more, or you can take also just 1. For demo purpose, I'm taking 2 here. Volume size 40. I'm taking more volume because it needs more volumes. Lots of things I'll insert here. Then I am identity access management with OIDC. OIDC should be true with I am open ID connection. Then add-ons name, add-ons EBS, AWS EBS CSI driver, Elastic Block Service CSI driver add-on should be add-on, like, you know, the Jenkins has plugin add-on is like this in the Kubernetes or in the YAML file like this. And well-known policies, EBS CSI controller policy has the CSI controller policy, looks like police or like rules, anything else. Here is the controller, this EBS CSI, it should be true. Yeah, looks fine, everything. Ask colon WQ, it's not ready. Now I have to write Eksctl create space hyphen f function, then cluster.yaml. Just I have created this cluster, okay. Just enter which one, please provide. Oh my goodness, my bad. See, I'm creating cluster, I did not say it which resource. Oh my goodness. Okay, should be cluster there. See here, Eksctl create cluster. More than 1,000 times I have created cluster. Maybe how much? Not 1,000, almost 10,000 maybe. See, almost 10,000 times I have created cluster, but yet I forgot to write here cluster. So real time is always different than your knowledge period or university period or learning period. Of course, first you should have the knowledge. Knowledge is like the iceberg, and knowledge is the bottom side, and in the real life is coming the iceberg tip on the top side. So most of the thing in your knowledge base, you know. So your practices, hands-on, everything should be had. For this reason, honestly, I started my YouTube channel specifically for AWS DevOps engineering. Lots of guys killing the times, having the name like DevOps Wala Bhaiya, like that, blah blah. Honestly, they are killing your time. They're expert, but you guys, everyone is not expert. So I'm not teaching you how to ride or how to drive the bicycle. I'm just you guys sitting, I'm making you are on the bicycle. Now I'm just showing you how to try the bicycle, okay? You will be falling many multiple times. Then once upon a time, you will know how to keep the balance, right? So here like that, I have started my project. I'm showing you again, if you missed. I started my project AWS DevOps from here. Three-tier deployment with VPC, Nginx, load balance, auto-scaling. Everything is here. This is very important. Then how to deploy front-end application with AWS S3. Why I'm here? Because it will take 15 minutes. Minimum 15 minutes. The CloudFormation stack. It's creating a stack. Let's see. What is CloudFormation? Okay. It's creating a stack. Create in process or in progress. So it will create lots of resources. At least 15 minutes it will take. So I'm showing you guys. This is actually like 20,000 or 25,000 in the USA. This bootcamp I'm giving you just free. See here, then deployment, how to deploy front-end application with S3. This is one part, part one, part two. Then how to deploy Nginx in Docker. This is part one, Docker. This is part two. This is part three, also Docker Swarm. You have to know the Docker Swarm. Then Kubernetes is I started. First the installation. Then how to deploy with Kubernetes. This is part two, part one. Part two is two, I think I divided two. Yes, that is part two. Then part three, one is coming like how to deploy application with EKS. CloudFormation, Prometheus, Grafana. So this is three part, this is bigger, honestly. So I parted one, two, three. Also to save my time also. Every day I cannot, after having the work, the night time, I cannot have the lots of energy. So, yes, this is the Prometheus Grafana part is finished here. And today I have started this one. Three-tier application deployment with EKS best practices. I'll show you the best practices. I have already showed how to install.ss. Everything in the SS file, so the best practices you can get. Install.ss. Where is install? EKS install tools. So everything to make your virtual machine smarter, latest, just full upgrade. Okay, not upgrade only, full upgrade. It should be full. Okay, this is very important. Every DevOps guys does not know that. I'm showing you. I'm lucky also, I learned it from my manager. My manager showed me full upgrade. He said me that every DevOps guys does not know that. Then also I have installed unzip first because I have to unzip this zip file. I have to unzip this zip file. Eksctl, then this GitHub has the release. Then CLI installation. CLI installation, guys, this is also interview question. Please learn. Please, please. I'm emphasizing this one. You must have to know CLI installation. First, you have to curl, then unzip. I am unzipping lots of things, not only this one, lots of things. Then unzipping, then sudo aws install. It should be after unzipping this file, install file will be working. Then just remove which one unzipped, aws cli v2 version 2.zip, and also aws should be removed to make free the volume. Guys, you have to know also the volume management, okay, because lots of unused files are left. Then for the spaces, shrinken or shrunk spaces, application does not run. That's the problem. You have to remove. This is very important. Okay, rm space hyphen fr or rf, anything else for removing the directories. Here is the AWS directories and just removing the file, and no need the fr. So here are the directories, so it needs that effort. Then kubectl installation. It's not coming in the interview question, but interview question is coming this one, must. And Eksctl installation is not coming also in the interview questions. Verify, checksum, but this guy is coming. Tar command, the zip file or .js file, how to extract xzf, tar, space hyphen, then xzf. It was so tough to rememorize for me. Maybe guys, it should be easy for you guys. Okay, last time interview question I have showed you. It's still taking time, just I'm making my video pause now. I'll be come back after having the my cluster, okay, coming. Yes, now this is showing good. Kubectl is not good. Eksctl cluster, June 24. EKS in this region is now ready. Okay, ready to go. Let's see. Kubectl get node. Yes, I have now two nodes, both are internal. So it's identifying with the IP. See the IP, 71 is last. This one is 213. Let's see, it's created or not. Also see the stack, CloudFormation stack. All are created first. See, and this is also interview question. Which one is created first? First is created the cluster, then add-ons, then node group, then add-ons EBS CSI driver, whichever I have given in the cluster.yaml. You can see get cluster.yaml. I have given which one to create. I have said to create the cluster June 24 EKS. It has been created first, then the node group, then IAM, then add-ons. Guys, I'm showing you the real life, okay? It cannot be honestly forgotten if you learn like this. First is cluster, whichever I have given in the YAML file, then add-ons, then node group. Actually, node group has showing this first here, but this is the, after cluster must be node group. Then add-ons, then AWS CSI driver. Now let's see in the EC2. It's running 3. One more thing I'm sharing you guys. After creating the resources, this is the window or your display. In real life, I'm watching like this. Just go to the EC2, this dashboard like that. How many instances running? 3. Auto scaling group is 1. Elastic IP working 1. Instances 3, this 3. And kubectl also 1. Security group is 6. 6 means it has been created for 2 instances, 2 public, 2 private. That means 4. Earlier I had 2 security groups, that means 6. Then volumes is 4. Why 4? Here is running 3, but volume is 4. Because let's see directly why the volume is 4. Here, these 3 volumes are created now for June 24 EKS, this cluster. This is my bastion volume. So 2 for nodes. This is for PVC, persistent volume claim. Persistent volume claim, see. I have also learned this one with you guys. Nobody cannot say that he knows everything, you know. Persistent volume claim, PVC also created. I not say to create the persistent volume. See here? In my kind, you can see. There is no PVC, right? But this is very, very important. Without persistent volume claim, PVC, Kubernetes cannot run. Cluster cannot run. See? Okay. Now go back to the instances. 3 instances, these 2 is created now, the node group. What is the node group? How many I said? Desired capacity is 2, right? T3 large. See here, this 2 is created now. And what kinds of? T3 large. T3 large. And see the details. Here is showing 213 and 26. Let's go earlier command. Get node. Here is 213. But it has given, this is the 213. Also, this is the reserved one for this. And here, this one, 71. This is the reserved one. So this is the 71, right? 71. 213. So cluster is good. Cluster has created lots of things. And let's see our VPC also. We should see. It should be created one more VPC. Where is the VPC? Yeah. Eksctl June 24 EKS. Then cluster. It has been created. See the resources map. Guys, always check it, resources map, NAT gateway for private and normal IGW here, and for the private has how many private? I have 2 private here, subnet. So for each subnet, you have to have separate route table. This is also interview question. For maybe 2 subnets private or 3 subnets private, so how many route tables? Must be, guys, you have to answer. For each private subnet should be had separate private route table. It talking privately with NAT. And also this one also talking privately with NAT. It looks like this NAT has 2 wives, right? Just making joke. Okay. So here are 2 girlfriends. Okay. But the public has only 1 route table. Here maybe million or hundreds or thousands public subnet, they all has only 1 route table. They're talking only 1 mobile. We're using 1 mobile, okay, with IGW. Okay, so for the NAT private, it has also created a NAT gateway. This is the, see the NAT gateway, June 24 EKS. It has created the NAT gateway also. And let's see the auto scaling. It should be created auto scaling because the instances has been configured or shooted from the auto scaling. Yeah, this auto scaler June 24 EKS. Here is the version showing up. Instances 2, desired capacity 2, mean max all are 2. Let's see some more. Okay, here details, desired 2, minimum 2, maximum 2. I did not change. If you guys need, you can change. It has also the ARN. If you like, you can take it. Then launch template. Auto scaling needs the launch template. So this is launch template that details T3 my Lars AMI. Everything is here. Security group, it has 2. Also, yeah, load balancer is still not. No need the load balancer right now. Okay, so sometimes launch template is lost. Sometimes you have to go see here in the EC2 panel. Launch template here. I have only one launch template. This one, June 24 EKS. See the launch template. The details, T3 Lars, security group, AMI, Amazon machine image IDs here. Something interesting showing you. This AMI is for mine separate. If I create AMI manually, then it should be here. Also, it should be have a snapshot on that time. But see now. Yes, so looks like it has been created finally, likely. Everything is here. This is the your checkbox or window, I think. Or window shopping, if you like. It's here, the window shopping. Okay. Make something smiling. And I have now here completed bastion creation. I automate the installation of prerequisite CLI, Kubectl, Eksctl. Then I have created the cluster. It's now midnight, so I'm giving the pause here. Then next video tomorrow, I'll create the backend deployment with environment variables in a declarative way, then install Helm and run MySQL, then configure the database, then run backend application with the help of ConfigMap, then run deployment. After running the backend any application, it's coming the deployment, okay? With the changed resources configuration, then I'll incorporate liveness probe, readiness probe, must be 2 interview questions. Then I'll create a custom Helm chart, how to create the Helm chart. This is also an interview question for the application, run it. And finally, I will incorporate Elasticsearch, Fluentd, and Kibana for logging. So after having the logging, you will feel the very much good, very much cool. And so let's connect tomorrow. Do practice. Have a great day or great night. Thank you very much.